Hoo-hoo, everybody. It's Wordstock time, and today's theme is story structure, and I want to introduce you to the deliciousness that is slice of life. I'm Joanne Ninjahan, and I'm the author of Antitoast via MMORPG. That's a lit RPG slice of life story, so I use it for my own work. Wordstock is an invention by Robert Jones, the story detective. You can find his wits on YouTube under the name The Story Detective. And I will post the playlist for today in the description of the video. A whole bunch of author tubers will tell you about different story structures or story structure per se. In their videos, Robert Jones will collect them in a playlist, and I post this playlist in the description below. So what is a slice of life? In literary parlance, the term slice of life refers to a storytelling technique that presents a seemingly arbitrary sample of a character's life, which often lacks a coherent plot, conflict, or ending. That's from Wikipedia. So they say slice of life is a storytelling technique. Some say slice of life is a genre, and some say slice of life is a story structure. The last some, that's me. I say it's a story structure, because in slice of life you don't have your three-act structure, you don't have your hero's journey. What you have is looking at the life of your protagonists, of your characters, under a looking glass. You enlarge every aspect of their life. Sometimes you follow them minute for minute or hour for hour. There's a very popular Japanese manga that's just one day in one girl's life told in half an hour. It always starts the same, it stops the same. So we don't have the usual beats in this kind of story. So a bit to the history. The term was coined by the French playwright Jean Julien around 1892. A play is a slice of life put on stage with art. He was part of the naturalism movement, where you aimed for a very high degree of realism. Then it was used as a derogatory term for television dramas in the 50s, and now it is popular in mangas and animes. You can divide stories into plot-driven and character-driven, and slice of life is an extreme example of character-driven storytelling. Plot is optional. What do you have to have in a slice of life? You have to have a strong theme like coming of age, school life. My novel is the strong theme gameplay and dealing with age-related issues on the other end of the spectrum of the coming of age, like aging as an old woman and mad science. So I've got three strong themes. And that might be too much. Then you have to have interesting characters. Instead of interesting, there can be other descriptive words like relatable characters. It has to be characters you can invest your emotions into them, because the characters are the story device that carries the whole story. Because you don't produce the tension through plot. So the characters have to be very solid, very good designed. In animes, they are often very cute girls, cute characters, could be a must-have for some subgenres of slice of life. There even is one YouTuber who said cute girls is a whole subgenre of slice of life. Cute girls doing cute things. Should-haves. Character development. Sure. And emotional impact. Instead of impact, other words would be alright too, like emotional investment into the characters or an emotional relatability, which also has ties to the strong theme. So in the slice of life, you don't have your typical Greek story structure. You don't have a plot. So there is absolutely the pitfall if you have a story which has nothing but a few nice scenes and you have no story structure, no clear story structure, a jumbled mess of a story structure, that you call this a slice of life. And this happens, yes? I have the problem with my story as well, that I use the word slice of life as an excuse for my shitty plot. It is a pitfall, and be beware of it. So this was a tiny bit of the wonderful story structure that is slice of life. And I really believe this is one of the story structures we will see in literature more in the next few years. Cinema has made the beginning with creators like Quentin Tarantino, that he shows more the small scenes like royal tears with cheese, a quarter pounder. And I believe we will see this kind of storytelling that focuses in part or even as a whole on the smart, short wonderfulness that is regular life more. Thank you for listening, and please check out the other entries of the Wardstock project. A link is in the description below. Bye bye!